And now I just saw a fantastic film here at the Provincetown International Film Festival called Splinters, and we're talking to the documentarian. It's his first film, and it's Adam Pesce.
Pesce, you got it.
Oh, Adam, welcome. Welcome to the Stephen Holt Show. Thank you for stopping by in that incredible film. My God, how long did it take you to make that?
Oh, thanks for having me, Stephen. The film took actually a number of years to complete, but I lived in Papua New Guinea for 9 months, and I went and lived there and learned the language and got malaria and was shooting by myself for 6 out of 9 months.
You've got malaria?
I
do. Do you still have it?
Yes, but don't worry, you can't get it at this range.
I know, I watched Survivor, so I know somebody on Survivor got malaria. It's not serious.
You're fine.
But it was so interesting about your film is that it's not just about surfing of all things in Papua New Guinea. I mean, that's what's so great about the Provincetown Film Festival is they show films that like you would never ordinarily decide to watch. And suddenly you're thrust into this whole new world that is intriguing but also quite violent.
Yeah, I never set out to make a surfing film. Although I love surfing films and I'm a surfer myself, I set out to make a documentary, a social documentary,
and you did. That's what it is. Yeah.
And it's ultimately more about how the surfboard is an icon of the West coming into this remote place,
yes,
and changing,
yes,
it for better or for worse is the question of the film. And I was really, really curious about how the surfing experiment is going to unfold for them, and what it, whether it's going to bring what they ultimately want, or whether it might bring some of the unsavory elements of the globalized world.
Well, it's unsavory in the fact that I was just shocked by the things you were constantly revealing about village life, like the women are bought.
Yeah, bride price is very common in Papua New Guinea.
Bride price, correct.
Is very common in Papua New Guinea and throughout the developing world. And for me, that
is that.
It's basically a woman is valued, and in order to take her as your wife, and you have to purchase her, and ultimately she will retain her maiden name until such time that the man has sufficiently paid for her, and then once this has happened, her family that she comes from no longer has to be responsible for caring for her. Now it's the men's family.
And there's a man who is the central character. I guess if we reveal who it is, we might reveal the ending of the film, so I won't name him, but he gets into all kinds of trouble because he's not paid his bride price or his back alimony or
something like that.
Yeah, there's one of the characters in the film is a really, really talented surfer, but also filled with pride and hubris, and that in a few ways comes up and is a central conflict of the film.
Yeah, because he I don't want to reveal the dramatic ending, but there was just one surprise after another. Not about surfing, but about these people and their lives, because you go into all their backstories. And again, the stuff about women in an almost all-female audience that we were watching, I hear these gasps. There's somebody in your film named Leslie, or one of the characters. Suddenly, everybody hates her, and they're burning her clothes. And what was that all about?
Surfing is actually bringing in, funnily enough, through this countercultural sport, it's bringing in Western egalitarian values, and that was something that was of interest to me. How is this really kind of popular Western sport gonna affect the lives of women in this village, and it's actually allowing them to surf in parts of the beaches where they wouldn't have been able to surf traditionally before, and that was, it's breaking a taboo, and now they're actually through these surfing clubs able to hold executive positions in them, and that was something that was of interest to me, because the sport is not just athletic, but it's also having social ramifications where the traditional, rather patriarchal society is coming head to head with a cultural force that's going to maybe dilute it and change it.
Well, what happened to this woman? It seemed like the whole town turned against her because she had an affair. with a white guy or something? Or
I don't want to comment. I don't want to comment too heavily about like some of these intricacies of the plot. But yeah, Leslie is certainly she's a contrarian and has a lot of She doesn't have many people like her in the village, so she really is blazing a trail for women surfing and this very kind of small town.
Yeah, it's stuff happens here. I was like, oh my god, thank god I don't live, because you think, oh, it's a tropical paradise, and then it's like, no, it isn't.
Right.
You for yourself.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it was a really incredible place, because you know, at once it really is a paradise of sorts. And you know, I saw children belly surfing and with this beautiful purity of play, and it was the most gorgeous thing I'd ever seen. But at the same time, you know, in the afternoon later, the mother of one of those children might be being beaten senseless, and it was this constant you know, strange like emotions for me, because it was someplace that I wanted to stay forever, because it was so beautiful and so pure, but it was also really tragic and really, really flawed. And that was something that was lifelike, and I wanted to make that was something that was a concern of mine. I wanted to make sure the film reflected that life and was lifelike.
It certainly was, and here we are in this sort of semi-island situation here in Provincetown, which all these things could be a plot. No, just kidding. But I think this film changed your life, because I think you are a filmmaker, sir, at this point. You really are.
Thanks, Stephen. This is my first film. I didn't go to...
Wow. And it did remind me of all the films that you, like...
Hoop Dreams. It reminded me a lot of Hoop Dreams.
Hoop Dreams is just such an incredible, incredible documentary. I was really, really drawn in by that film and the honesty and earnestness with which it was made. And I'd never made a film before, so each process was for the first time. And I just knew that I wanted to make an intimate film. And you know, a big part of that was going and living in the village, being a part of the life as it unfolded, and learning the language, and becoming very close with all the people that were ultimately on screen. They were all my friends, and I loved them very dearly, with flaws and intricacies and all.
Yeah, so I was in the first traveling down memory lane here. I didn't mean to do it, but I'm going to do it. It's my show. I was in the first ever reality TV series called American Family.
Right.
Remember? Yes. Remember? The Loud Family.
Yeah. That
in the 70s.
And it was they just made a feature film about it, correct? An HBO film, is that?
They could very well, but I wasn't in that one. But I was in the play, if you remember, that Lance, who turns out to be revealed as the gay son, and he became famous, Lance Loud, takes his very uptight, beautiful mother to see this gay experimental play, and I was in it. In drag, yes, I was. So there I was on reality TV, little did I know, blazing the way. And here I am, all these years later, still doing a weekly reality TV. It's my reality here at the Provincetown Field. Isn't this place fabulous?
I'd taken the red eye from Los Angeles, and
your eyes aren't red.
Yeah, right. I just went straight from the puddle jumper to the screening, and you know, once on my way through the town, I was like, everyone's just so happy.
They are.
The sun was out. Everyone was in the best of moods, and it's just been incredible being here.
Either it's because the summer has just started and it's the first week and it's the film festival, or these people are just like this all the time, which is a beautiful thing. In any case, your film, Splinters, is a beautiful thing, and I think you're going to be hearing a lot from Adam Pesce, and you're going to be hearing a lot about this film. Thank you so much for taking the time today here on Commercial Street, right in the middle of Provincetown. Thank you, Adam.
Thanks, Stephen. I'm going to go and mingle with some happy people now.
Okay.